ओम श्री साई राम। कृष्ण कृष्ण गोविंद कृष्ण गोपाल बाल कृष्ण, नंद नंदना भक्त चंदना गान लोल कृष्णा। कृष्ण कृष्ण गोविंद कृष्ण गोपाल बाल कृष्णा, नंद नंदना भक्त चंदना गान लोल कृष्णा। सुंदर वदना सरोज नयना राधा प्रिय कृष्णा। सुंदर वदना सरोज नयना राधा प्रिय कृष्णा। यादव कृष्ण यशोदा कृष्ण सत्यम साई कृष्ण। यादव कृष्ण यशोदा कृष्ण सत्यम साई कृष्ण। कृष्ण कृष्ण गोविंद कृष्ण गोपाल बाल कृष्ण। ओम श्री साई राम। मेनी अ टाइम्स वी वंडर हाउ एंड व्हाई टू सरेंडर टू गॉड, to anybody for that matter, because everybody wants to live his or her life independently on his own terms and conditions and face the consequences whatever be the situation. That is our upbringing. We have to live our passion, we have to live our dreams, we have to realize our dreams, what not. It is very difficult to truly surrender. But many people are, is it necessary to surrender? Why we should surrender? Because then God has given us power of discrimination. He has given us intelligence, the human intelligence. We should know off and on we can, in difficult situation, we pray to Him for some special grace when we are in difficult situation. But normally, who wants to surrender to anybody? Good. Swami says, good. But you surrender, you bow down your head when you go to a barber for haircut. The barber is having a sharp instrument. You just bow down. Sometimes many of us close our eyes. The barber is not known to us. Many times we go to some unknown place and we need a haircut. We go to any barber shop, any person, unknown person, holding knife, holding sharp instrument. And we put our head down, closed eyes. Because we trust that he will not do any mischief. There is no guarantee. We don't take guarantee. See, if I am here, you have to give me a guarantee that you will not do any mischief or cut here and there. And if I am bleeding, then you have to pay for it. Or we don't put CCTV cameras to know and all that. We go normally because that is the convention. We do it regularly, every one of us. Same thing when we have a driver, we give keys to the driver. Of course, if the driver is known, manchidi, but many times we hire a cab. The cab is unknown, the driver is unknown, that we hire it online and somebody comes and online everything is done. Even we give permission to our ladies and kids to be driven, knowing very well that many a times there are reports and news reports that many drivers are not as reliable as they appear to be. Many things have happened, we know it. Yet, because if we are to survive in this society, then we had to be what we call be practical. Good. Swami says, good, manchiri. We trust our boss. I know many IAS experienced brilliant officers in PMO who have experience of so many years. Their boss may not be as competent or as knowledgeable as they are, but yet they will not move an inch without taking permission or consent from their boss, because according to them, the boss knows the best. And most of us, we surrender to our wives at home if we want to live peacefully. I know many persons, so-called very intellectuals, practical people, who live with their arrogance and ego outside their house. But inside, they become totally different. We know it. Let us accept it. Forget the external things. Many times we surrender to barber or driver or to our political bosses or official bosses or wives or husbands at home because we have no options, isn't it? Frankly, honestly, let us accept it. But do we not surrender to our mindless senses and senseless mind? How many times do we follow our own discrimination, our scientific upbringing and our rational and our logic when we eat wrong food, have wrong drinks at wrong time, in wrong place, in wrong manner, with wrong people, in wrong doses? Where does our discrimination and everything go? It is only when it is question of surrendering to some god or guru, then all our logic, our rational thinking, our discrimination, everything, our degrees, authority, common sense, practicality, everything comes in forefront. Good, manchidi. God is happy even with that, okay. But if we believe that we are the performers, not puppets, even a performer, any performer for that matter, he may be the top ranking number one performer. When he comes on the stage to perform, he will not know how to deliver the dialogue unless the director tells him the script, the storyline, the manner in which this dialogue is to be delivered. He may have done 100 of movies before, but in that particular situation, in that particular movie, how he has to deliver, how he has to react. Performance is his, but direction has to be of the director who knows the entire script. Because there are so many options even to deliver a dialogue, simple dialogue. Whether to deliver it in high tone, low tone, in comedian tone or serious tone, who knows? The performer would not know. He just comes in. We have seen shootings in our childhood and nowadays, shootings are available on YouTube. Any movies we can see. So, in that case, we have to depend upon the directors because he knows the best. And we have such divine director who has declared that Panchat Mahavakyas, I do not commit mistakes. Whatever I do or omit to do is for good of all. Nothing can ever happen without my intent will. Trust in my wisdom. And in the last sentence, he reveals his authority, his cosmic authority. Learn to love my uncertainty, my unpredictability. Because I know the best. Our so-called human intelligence, human mind, with all the discrimination power, all the Google knowledge, all the information, all the talents, all the experiences, all the information stored in our head. Our vision, our wisdom is always limited. We do not know the next moment. None of us. That is why he offered himself to be the charioteer, the driver of his beloved Arjuna. He said, I will not take any weapons. But he wanted to play an important role. Weapons he will not perform, no director will perform on this camera. He will give you all everything, he will decide, he will provide everything, whatever is required to perform your role. He will tell you how to deliver, he will demonstrate 100 times, retakes, no issues. But he will, director himself will not perform your role. Even if the director decides to play a role, be an incarnation, be a playing hero or side a character actor in the movie, he will play his role, not your role. That is how Swami used to do. Many times people used to wonder, say, Swami is asking what is the time, what project. He will ask the warden, he will ask the organization, trust people, as if he knows nothing. That is the difference between human mind and God mind. We humans know nothing, we act as if we know everything. Whereas God knows everything, but he acts as if he knows nothing. He would ask from Indulal Shahji, from Colonel Jogarao, and they would sometimes really feel that they have to advise Swami. He himself told me this. But he said they cannot function unless I create that Maya. But off and on he has to show that he knows everything. That also the experience of all these sages, all these people who worked with Swami for years, they all are sages of highest order. Swami made them play that role. He deluded them into believing that he doesn't know. He deluded the doctors that multi-organ failure, that he fell down and all that. He is, I repeatedly says, all the Oscars award would go to him for acting. There is no other second opinion on that. Straight away. He knows how to act and how to react. How to reveal. Rama never revealed his divinity. Krishna never concealed his divinity. This God is unique avatar. He reveals and conceals his divinity simultaneously by the same act. I have given so many examples in my previous talks. And that is the beauty of his, what he calls Natakam, Sutradhari. That is why we enjoy him. So surrendering to him is actually getting connected to him. We surrender our tap to the tank in our language. But what we actually do, we connect our tap to the tank, overhead tank. The tap has to be lower, at lower level than the tank level. Can we say, no, I'll not surrender, my tap would be above the overhead tank. Manchidi, keep it. Water will not flow to you. So you have to position yourself, be humble enough. When you are keeping yourself connected, you are benefited. You have to connect your electricity, everything to the source. If you are disconnected, you have to face. God has no issues. He is not eager that all you surrender. Surrendering is actually getting connected to him. And getting connected to whom? The body gets connected to mind. Without mind, the body cannot function by itself. The same blood, the same consciousness is now operating through this body, isn't it? But the nose cannot see, the eyes cannot smell, the ears cannot digest food. There are different organs operating with the same blood, same consciousness throughout our body. Everybody, like the same current flowing through our all the wiring, electricity wiring in our house. But the fan will not give light. The tube light will not give us air. Just because the current is same, the voltage is same, everything same, wiring same. It depends upon the instrument through which the current operates. The same seed becomes the roots, the trunk, the branches, the tree, the fruit, the flower, the leaves. The chemical properties, the physical properties, the market value of each and every product is different. But the seed, okkate kada, seed is one. So same consciousness is operating. But we have to, the fruit, the flower, the tree has to be connected to the roots to get the nourishment. You have to water the roots, get connected to the roots. If the tree is uprooted, the flowers, the fruits will decay. They will die down. Not instantly. It takes time. Depends upon which flower, which fruit, and which tree is this. A tree is known by the fruit it bears. That is why Swami says you are known by the company that you keep, that you grow with. So we have to be connected in our own interest, to our own highest self, to our own best self, noblest self, truest self. God is that, our truest, highest, noblest self. And this Satya Sai is manifestation of our truest and highest self, each one of us. And that self is one. Our bodies are different. Even the twins have some difference. Our minds are 100% different because mind is made up of desires, of thoughts. Even the child in the womb of mother dreams differently than mother. When he starts dreaming, thinking. The body is different. The mind is different. Sometimes people come and tell me, so many young couples, uncle, our minds are totally different. I say it has to be different. On the contrary, if both have same identical minds, then it is a problem. Then one of you is unnecessary, as they say. If both are identical in everything, then why would God create? Identical productions are done in factories, not with God. God creates everybody as a unique. If you make a movie, for example, of a beggar on the street, on his life, then the beggar, the insignificant, unnoticed, irrelevant beggar whom we call, will become hero of the movie of his life if it is made. He is the hero of his life. Everybody is unique. Everybody is hero of his or her life. So we all are unique. We all are special. And we all must keep connected to our source, to the roots, for our own nourishment, to get what we actually need to get. And it is a humbling experience. And humility is hallmark of great personalities. Arrogant people are stupid people. They don't know what to be arrogant about. They are like a frogs in the well. This entire universe, so many galaxies, so many suns, so many earths, so many stars, every star containing so many suns, moons and earths. In that this earth planet is this tiny dot. In that dot, these five continents, in that five continents, this dot, Asia, in that dot, India, in that dot, our state and our township and our street and our house, and we, where do we exist? This foolishness. We have to be wise enough to know that we know nothing. And we have to be wise enough to know that He alone knows everything. Keep connected and remain protected and benefited. Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba Ji Ki Jai.